rigidity modulus or shear modulus of elasticity. This is from a topic, mechanical properties of solids. You know, what do you mean by elasticity? It is the property of the material by virtue of which it is able to regain its original state when you remove the applied external force. Here we are going to talk about the shape of the body and the modulus that protects the shape of the body. So let us consider a body like this, who is in a rectangular shape. This is the body that we are taking, having a length L and a, say, breadth B. Now, let us arrange in such a way that its lower surface is fixed. It's not movable. I have fixed it permanently. And we are applying a force horizontally on the upper surface of the body. So what happens when you keep the lower surface fixed and apply the force only on the upper surface horizontally is the lower surface will be there itself, but the upper surfaces will shift. That means the shape of the body will change from a rectangle. The shape is changed from, say, ABCD original shape to ABC dash and D dash, such that there is an angle turned at the vertical by an angle theta. So this is the force who is changing the shape of the body. So the corresponding stress is called something like shearing stress. Shearing stress is the stress that's acting on the shape of the body. Therefore, the force is causing a change in the shape of a body. Could be defined as the shearing force per unit area of cross section. Let us say area of cross section is A. Now there is a corresponding change in the shape of a body. The corresponding strain is called something like shearing strain. Shearing strain is defined as ratio of shift of the upper layer when compared with the lower to the perpendicular distance between the two layers. Let us try to understand. This is the shift of the upper layer. It could be either DD dash. This is the perpendicular distance between the layers. That's nothing but the breadth of the rectangle. So I can write shift of the upper layer as either CC dash or DD dash, by the perpendicular distance as either AC or BD, or we have called it like a breadth of the rectangle. Anyway, this is nothing but the angle. This is nothing but the opposite side. This is nothing but the adjacent side. So this is nothing but equal to actually tan theta. Being the angle theta is small, so we can say, basing on that, the shearing strain is nothing but equal to the theta itself approximately. Now, we know within the, as per the Hooke's law, stress is line, therefore shearing stress is also directly proportional to shearing strain. Shearing stress is force by directly proportional to shearing strain is shift of any of the upper layer by the perpendicular distance between the layers, or even we can write the theta also. We can eliminate the proportionality with a constant, which is nothing but the modulus of elasticity, which is called as rigidity modulus, shown with a letter something like eta into theta. Or of course, in the place of theta, I can write cc dash by b also, where eta is the proportionality constant called. So I can write rigidity modulus eta as force by area and theta. And be careful and clear in understanding that eta doesn't depend on either stress or strain. Rather, it depends on the nature of that material. It depends on nature of material. So eta is a measure of nature of the material, which tells you how strong the material is in protecting its shape. That means if eta is large, it is a very rigid body and it is very difficult to change the shape of a body. You know, diamond is a material having high rigidity modulus. Having high rigidity modulus, to change the shape of the body. Difficult to change the shape of diamond. You need another diamond, in fact, for that to make it happen. Thus, rigidity modulus is a way of measuring how good the body is or how bad the body is in protecting its own shape. Thank you for watching. Keep coming back for more and more video lessons. Thank you.